Precision is something that is valued in experimental science. And while there are many precise measurements that have been made over the years, there is one that is truly impressive. And that is the measurement of how strong a magnet an electron is. The technical term for that, by the way, is the magnetic moment of the electron. Now, that might sound like an esoteric topic, and I suppose it is if you were the kind of person who lacks curiosity and refinement. But you are watching a physics video, which means that you're my kind of people. So I'm going to tell you about a really cool and extremely precise measurement that is not only instrumental in proving the theory of quantum electrodynamics, but is also at the forefront of modern research. I made a video on the theory of QED, which you can watch if you're interested in that sort of thing. But in this video, I want to concentrate more on the experimental side. While there's a lot wrong about this mental image, you can picture the electron as a tiny spinning ball of electric charge. And if you spin a charge, you make a magnet, plain and simple. Now, there are a number of ways you can measure how strong a magnet is, but the easiest way is to put the magnet in an external magnetic field. Just like a spinning top will precess because of gravity, a magnet will precess around the bigger magnetic field. By watching the precession, we can determine precisely the magnetic moment of the electron. So that's the basic idea. The electron has a particular electric charge and a particular spin, which happens to be a half, and using straightforward traditional electromagnetic theory, you can calculate how strong a magnet it should be. There are many ways you could write the numerical value for this quantity depending on the units you pick. So what we do is pick the most convenient set of units possible, and in those units, the predicted magnetic moment is just the number one, or unity. This just makes life easier. But if you want to see the number in, say, metric units, you can Google the term Bohr magneton. But I'm just going to use the convenient units in which an electron with a spin of 1/2 is predicted to have a magnetic moment of precisely 1. In science, prediction isn't good enough. So, in 1947, an American physicist with the unlikely name of Polycarp Kutch measured the magnetic moment of the electron and got a number that was 1.00119. So the measured number was very close to 1, but different. And his measurement was precise enough that he knew that this wasn't measurement error. So this was cool, and it was a big deal at the time. It proved that the simplest theory wasn't quite right. The tiny shift, which was just shy of 0.12%, was real. And to explain it, physicists needed the theory of quantum electrodynamics, or QED. 1947 was about 70 years ago, and we've improved our experimental and calculational techniques. That means that these days we can test the theory of QED to incredible precision. The current measured value for the magnetic moment of the electron is 1.00115965218 1, while the predicted value is 1.00115965218 2. You can see that the prediction and the measurement agree exactly, digit for digit, for 12 places. Where they start to disagree, it's due to known uncertainties in both the prediction and the measurement. In fact, within uncertainties, the two numbers agree. To give you a sense of scale, that's like predicting and measuring the diameter of the Earth with an accuracy of 1/5 the diameter of a human hair. This is crazy accurate. Anytime you can get that kind of agreement between a measurement and a prediction means that you're doing something right. And from this exercise, physicists have concluded that the theory of QED is an accurate description of the laws of the universe. There are plenty of other examples where the calculations and measurements of QED agree, but this is the most precise. If you're looking for another example that is less numeric and more mind-blowing, QED also predicts that empty space isn't empty at all, but rather a constantly writhing, bubbling place with matter and antimatter particles constantly appearing and disappearing. You can take a look at my video on quantum foam if that interests you. Despite QED's incredible success, there is a research effort in which this topic possibly points to undiscovered physics. When scientists turned the precision of QED to investigating the properties of the muon, which is kind of like the electron's heavier cousin, there are tantalizing hints of new physics. When physicists study the magnetic moment of the muon, there is a discrepancy between the prediction and the measurement. And whenever data and calculations don't agree, that could well mean that you found something that your theory can't predict. We scientists have a name for that. We call it a discovery. The story of the magnetic moment of the muon is cool enough to warrant its own video. If you want details, I got details, but there and not here. The bottom line is that both the theory and the measurements of QED agree to parts per trillion, making it the most precise physics theory ever proposed. And anytime you get that level of agreement, you know you did something right.